The MPs raised their concern during a meeting held to consider the Petroleum Supply Amendment Bill of 2023, where Ruth Nankabirwa, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, informed the committee that the open tender system used in Kenya has exposed Uganda to occasional vulnerability to access petroleum products, with Kenyan government prioritizing their local companies.
Why do you want to put the middlemen in there to keep the money for nothing? Now, my concern, Chair, is as long as Vito is there, and then UNOC is getting from Vito, tell me how I will go and get cheaper fuel from the petrol station. It's already controlled by Vito, the price.
According to the government, Vito Bahrain will finance supply of petroleum products up to the delivery points in Kenya and Tanzania and allow UNOC to pay for the imports after receiving payments from the oil marketing company.
This only opens for Vitol. Vitol, who failed through competitive bidding to import fuel in Kenya, this law we are making seeks to open up only for Vitol to be able to import fuel in Kenya. That's the discrimination you're talking about. Why don't you make a law that will enable any other Ugandan company that would like to import for Uganda to be able to import for Uganda through Kenya?
Yes, we. So, it is entering into an agreement to import from Vitol. It can enter into an agreement to import with from any other entity.
Put it. You know, it's definitely going to get the oil from Vitol. Looking at this.
Honorable Minister, please supply the Attorney General with...
Committee members expressed fears to the Attorney General, Chidiyo Wachwanuka, that if such a move wouldn't go against the earlier Constitutional Court ruling against monopolies in Uganda.
We are against monopoly of Vitol, because Vitol is a problem on expense.
The MPs also asked the Attorney General to explain why UNOC entered into an agreement with Vitol before the Petroleum Supply Amendment Bill was enacted, to which Nankabirwa said that the agreement would only take effect upon the passing of the law by Parliament.
The law provides a monopoly to UNOC, but that should not blind us on what is behind the scene. Because from the presentation of the minister, on what she also made in the media, UNOC is already, or government of Uganda is already in agreement with Vitol.
While defending the enactment of the bill, Chiwanuka warned that the failure by Uganda to end reliance on Kenya by January 2024 would condemn Uganda to another year-long contract with Kenya.
What we are discussing here is a principle. The principle of giving UNOC a monopoly to import. I'm requesting members not to get clouded so much by the person whom they are doing the business with. Because that's where we're going to get to miss the point. UNOC currently does not have the muscle, but you want it to grow into an entity that can actually do this on its own. It has a partner it has been working on for smaller product. For how many years? 3 years or something? 3 years. They've been importing with them, and you have been seeing this on the balance sheet, but no one was very unhappy about the support of Vitol in making UNOC some money over the years.
But MPs questioned the capacity of UNOC to take charge of all the petroleum products imports in Uganda if the company has even failed to manage fuel reserves in Jinja.
Do all this work, import, transport, and distribute. You don't have capacity. For now, you don't have capacity.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. That's why I'm saying we need to understand, if you are a weakling, there is a way you can find someone to support you. So that's why we need to understand how Vitol is going to support UNOC to be able to execute this.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.